these impact factors affecting the location of any industry are influenced by the two factors as geographical and non-geographical. Geographical and non-geographical factors. Non-geographical factors. Non-geographical factors. Geographical factors include as a land. Land require a vast extensive area, especially as a infertile lands are preferably used for a location of industries. Location of industries. Land is a basic requirement. This is as active factor of a production. Land, labor. In industries, as labor used in a two form as a skilled and unskilled. Two kinds of labors required for industries as two types of labor desirable for a location of industries as skilled and unskilled labor. Skilled and unskilled labor. Skilled and unskilled labor desirable for location of industries. Location of industries. Unskilled labor required for the unskilled labor required for mining processes, for extraction of material for the production, and skilled labor required for running of machines. Labor is also plays important role in a location of industries for which as industries are generally located in such parts of the world, such parts of a country where population available in abundance. Those areas which are the densely populated areas, high density of a population in such of the areas are favorable for location of industries because in our populous areas are favorable to provide as a cheaper labor availability, cheaper labor for location of industries. That's why industries are preferably located and in such areas where population existence is a more. Neither in such areas where population is a lesser. Because if the labor is a lesser, then under such circumstances, it will demand for a more wages. Cheaper labor is preferably growing in such areas of a high population. So industries are located in those of areas, land labor. Next as a raw material. Raw material, whatever is produced in industry for which as a raw material is desirable. And that's why as industries are located as near to the sources of raw materials. If the industries are located in some outskirts areas where the then the industry has to spend their valuable sources for transporting the materials. It will increase as a cost of production. If the iron and steel industry is located in somewhere outskirts in Punjab, then what will be happen? Raw material, it will be as a bulky material, bulky iron and steel, raw iron ore, it will be as imported from the Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal towards the parts of Punjab. Means that particular industrialist has to spend some amount of their money on a transport of materials. After the transporting, such material will use for a manufacturing of goods. Afterwards, a manufacturing of these goods. Then that kind of a good, it will be as expensive comparatively the other number of goods which are manufactured from the such industries which are located near to the sources of raw material. But some of the industries are there which we can be located at anywhere. For example, pharmaceuticals. Pharmaceutical industries or cosmetics. They can be as located at any part of a country. The reason as a lighting weight. The raw material used in such industries has a smaller in quantities and light in weight. Such type of industries are known as footloose industries. which use as a lightweight materials. Lightweight raw materials are known as footloose industries. It can be as a locale at any part of a country due to as their low, lesser raw material and light in weight. It can be as located at any part of a country. Clear? So raw material, it should be as well, but most number of large-scale industries desirable, their raw material should be available as nearer to the industry. Next, climate. Climate playing as an important role for the location of industries. For example, cotton textile industries, these are located in such parts of a country where the hot and humid weather conditions are prevails. Because in humid and wet climatic conditions, it strengthens the thread. For which, as some of the industries, they are providing us artificial conditions for maintaining the humidity. But for such kind of the climatic conditions, such kind of artificial conditions require the capital investment. To decrease as a cost of production, industries are locating their industries in such areas where humidity as a prevails throughout the year, means coastal regions. That's why the India's 90% of cotton textiles are concentrated on coastal parts of Ahmedabad, Bombay, Vadodara, Rajpipla, Raipur, Rajkot, in such of the areas of Gujarat and Maharashtra, because of availability of humid weather conditions. But as compared to this, iron and steel industries, they are preferably located in dry weather conditions. Why? Because when water comes in contact of iron, then what will be happen? Iron rusts. That's why iron and steel industries are concentrated in southeastern parts of a country, in leeward sides of eastern Ghats, western slopes of eastern Ghats, in such parts as a dry weather conditions are prevails, which are favorable for a location of iron and steel industries. Clear? So that's why as climate as an important indicator for location of industries. Next, as means of transport. Industry, it should be well connected with the means of transport. To import the material, raw material from production sites towards the industry, and afterwards the manufactured goods exporting from an industry towards a market, for which as a good network of a means of transport is desirable. Means of transport is desirable for a location of any industry. Location of any industry. Because when we are talking about the location of industries which require as a more raw material, heavy bulky raw material, coal for running of machines, under such circumstances, they need as a well connection of a railways. These places should be connected with the railways, through which they can carry the material in a larger quantities. Through railways, they can carry the material in a larger quantities towards the industry, and afterwards the industries towards the ports, they can export their materials towards other countries of the world. Well, network of transport are desirable, and such means of transport are generally as growing in a level surfaces, in a plain surfaces. That's why industries are concentrated in a leveled areas, in a plains comparatively in a mountainous and a plateau regions. Next, as some markets, goods are manufactured. Now, if they will not as a sell, how can an industrialist it can earn the profits? So for which as a markets are desirable. Markets should be as located near to the industries, and the demand of a product, as according to the demand, goods are manufactured in industry. Goods manufactured in industries as according to the demand of product in society. Next, as water. Water also playing as an important role, but it is considered as a secondary agent for location of industries. Because water can be as a necessity, can complete through the underground surfaces also, or through the pipeline transportation. through the pipeline transportation, but it is also as influencing, it is also demanding in a industries. In cotton textile industries, water required for a washing and dyeing purposes. In iron and steel industries, thermal power stations, nuclear power stations, aluminium smelting centers, water desirable for a cooling purposes. So that's why as the industries are located in a such areas of a country where as a water availability as a available as naturally or artificially or artificially. So these factors are collectively responsible for the location of any of industry in our country. Location of industries in our country. Next are the non-geographical factors as capital investment. Capital. Well, huge quantities of capital desirable for location of industries. And that capital as preferably provided to the banks. Banks given as a credit to the industries on which as the capital availability, use of a capital for a improvements in a technology, payment wages to the laborers, purchasing of a raw material for which as a such desire, capital required in a huge quantities. So those areas, those parts of a country where credit facilities are easily provided through the banks, such areas are preferred to locate as the industries. And last as the government policies. Government policies. Favorable government policies in which government should be as a government should favorable for industries. Those states of a country where as the government supportive for a location of a industries, it liberalized their policies. It given as a relaxations to the production centers through which they can produce as a goods in a larger quantities. They can produce the goods in a larger quantities in such areas where the government has supportive for the industrial growth. Supportive for industrial growth, for which as government has providing as a infrastructure. Government providing the infrastructure at low cost. Means of transport are developed by the government. Government providing as a better health facilities and educational facilities. Where as a better health facilities and education facilities are there, people will prefer to live in such areas. That's why the people are migrating from a rural towards urban areas. Rural towards urban areas. And government is responsible for a such kind of a dash. Health, education, transport, drinking water, sanitation, hygienic environment conditions are the examples of dash. Complete the blank. Who will complete the blank? Yes, Shivansh Agarwal. Low cost. These kinds of services are neither as handled by the private companies which are work generally for the profits. These services are generally provided by the government sector, by the public sector. So keeping in mind all of such geographical factors and locational factors of industries, the most appropriate and profitable site is selected. Industrialization of any area initiates the urbanization and subsequent. Yes, Simanpreet.
सर पहले आपने जियोग्राफिकल फैक्टर्स में पावर भी कराया था
यस पावर आल्सो इंक्लूड्स अंडर जियोग्राफिकल फैक्टर्स इट मे हैव स्किप्ड फ्रॉम माय माइंड पावर इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर रनिंग ऑफ मशीन्स इफ द इंडस्ट्री इज देयर इन सच इंडस्ट्रियल यूनिट्स ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल इनटू द फिनिश्ड गुड्स फॉर व्हिच एज इंडस्ट्रीज आर रिक्वायर्ड and present as a most number of industries are run through as a power supply. Regular power supply is desirable for a location of industries. That's why industries are located in such areas where coal available as the nearest to the industry. Coal available for the industry as nearest to it. Or either any of a dam, the multi-purpose river valley projects, it should be as a located to the nearer to the or accessible towards the industry. Two, the regular supply of a power. So the whatever the expenses of industries, they can as a complete and manufacture the goods with the support of a modern machinery. Yes, go samajod. Go samajod Singh. Your hand is still raised. What do you want to ask? Good summer, Joe. I think that's why as their cameras are not working. Your cameras are not working. Physically, you are not present in near to the screen. So, industrialization of any area initiates the urbanization and subsequent modernization. Infrastructural facilities intensify the water and power supply. Efficient banking and credit facilities and transport network. Industrialization attracts the labor force and area, and area becomes the hub of the activities generating the diverse employment. Developing service sectors. In short, a center transforms into a town or a city. Industrialization helps in removing the regional disparities and eradicate poverty and unemployment, which has existing in conditions and removes the poverty. Our policy, it should be diffuse industrial. Earlier, the industrial development had colonial character. That is, as an industrial development took place in areas like as a Kolkata, Chennai, Bombay, Kolkata, Chennai, Madras, Bombay, and Delhi. At the British time, during the British age,
sir, aapki voice nahi proper aa rahi.
These kinds of changes were there, which has influencing as the growth of Bombay. Such of the cities during as a British age were the most developed, like as a Delhi, Bombay, Madras, which now as a presently known as a Chennai, and Delhi, Calcutta. These were known as now am I audible?
Sir, आपकी voice crack बहुत कर रही है.
अभी ठीक है?
नहीं sir.
I think it's a technical problem. अभी yes now.
No sir.
Okay. Is from the 10D, 10th D, roll number 36. 10th D, roll number 36. Raise your hand.
अब नहीं आ रही सर.
नहीं आ रही अब.
सर बीच में अटकती है.
But it's due to the technical problem. We can't do anything for it. From 10th D, 36 from 10th D, 39 from the 10C. 39 from 10C. Roll number 39 from 10C. Raise your hand. Both of such roll numbers. 36, 10th D. 39, 10C. Shivansh Agarwal. Shivansh.
Yes, sir.
During British age, British was at their early phase of their development. They started to develop the four important cities named as a Bombay, Madras, Calcutta, and Delhi. What they called to it? These cities were known as a Shivansh.
Sir, port.
Delhi is a port? Really? Shivansh? बच्चे दिल्ली से
मैंने
कोई नई चीज बता दी जसलीन टेंसी जसलीन टेंसी यस जसलीन आंसर
यस सर
व्हाट द ब्रिटिशर्स कॉल्ड टू द सच सिटीज व्हिच वर डेवलप्ड ड्यूरिंग द ब्रिटिश एज बॉम्बे मद्रास दिल्ली एंड कलकत्ता लेकिन बड़ा होगा
सर बाकियों का बात सर बॉम्बे और मद्रास तो मेरे हिसाब से पोर्ट सिटीज है दिल्ली
दिल्ली क्या एक वर्ड यूज करते थे वो इन सब के लिए यस बिशप जोत
मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज
मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज आर दो सिटीज हुज इट्स पॉपुलेशन हैज मोर देन 1 करोड़ हम इंडिपेंडेंस से पहले की बात कर रहे हैं जब ब्रिटिशर्स आए थे Around 1764, when the Battle of Buxar held afterwards, these first four cities were developed by the Britishers, Delhi, Madras, Bombay, and Calcutta. These were not at that time as the metropolitan cities. I'm still waiting for the answer. Harshit Sahni, 10 feet. Harshit Sahni, 10 feet. Answer. Yes, Shivan.
Sir, presidency.
Very good. Presidency. These were the presidencies, which were after developed by Britishers under the process of industrialization. So industrialization, your industries were set up in a such areas. Industries were set up in a such areas, except as a Delhi. Now, yes, this is a break. Madras, Bombay, and Calcutta, these were as developed as a port cities. Port cities. Bombay given to the Britishers by the Portuguese ruler as the dowry. As dowry. Yes, Amritpal, what do you want to ask? Amritpal Singh.
Sir, kaise voice crack kar rahi hai.
So during as a colonial rule, such cities, Bombay, Madras, Calcutta and Delhi, these were as the major centers of a development. Government, British government, it emphasized as the more growth of industries in a such areas for improvements, for which as a large number of workforce coming from the outskirts towards as a outskirts means as a less developed areas towards a such four presidencies. These presidencies. So to the industrialization and urbanization. More development occur in parts of India. Industrialization and urbanization, they go hand in hand. Cities provide as a ready market and infrastructural facilities. Other industries also take as a such advantage of existing facilities and get established. So those smaller towns which are developed under influence of a larger cities, or a large-scale industries. Those areas are known as the urban economies or urban economies or agglomeration economies. Those economies or those towns which are developed under influence of a larger cities, larger industries are known as the urban economies or agglomeration economies. Example, Noida and Gurgaon. Due to the influence of a Delhi, Noida, Gurgaon, these two areas develop now as presently becomes as a more developed areas. More developed due to influence of Jalandhar and Ludhiana, the smaller towns which develop as their adjoining areas, Gurgaon, Nakodar, these areas are the examples of agglomeration economies or urban economies. agglomeration economies or urban economies? Yes, Daksh.
Sir, agglomeration तो वो नहीं होता जब सारी सारी states कट्ठी सारी states की जो industries होती है वो कट्ठे होके फिर काम करते हैं.
Small areas क्यों develop हुए? क्योंकि large scale industries are attracting their concentration of industries. Another example is just Sonalika tractors. सुना होगा आप सबने. Sonalika tractors. It's in Hoshiarpur. Yes, Daksh. सुना है? Daksh.
हाँ जी सर.
So Sonalika tractors in Hoshiarpur, which has required as a little number of materials. Sonalikas are not manufactured goods. Goods industry के अंदर सामान को assemble किया जाता है. Tractors are selling in a market. Clear? Daksh, are you there?
नहीं हूँ सर.
Okay. Fagwara, there is as a GNA. GNA. Do you know what has manufactured in a GNA? Which thing has a manufactured in GNA? Fagwara just has a 17 kilometers away from a Jalandhar. Daksh, answer. Kya banaya jata hai wahan par?
Sir, yaad kar rahe ho.
Yaad kar rahe ho. Ki search kar rahe ho. Wo pata hoga. They are having their own university also. GNA University.
Steel.
Steel बनाते हैं. पंजाब में steel कहाँ से आएगा? Steel बनाने के लिए iron चाहिए. मैंने कहा अगर iron यहाँ पे लाया जाएगा, it will increase cost of production. वो सामान तो महंगा बहुत होगा. Transportation के ऊपर अगर expenses लगा, वो steel कहाँ से बनाएंगे? Yes, Daksh. NC, Jasnan Singh. Thank you, Daksh. Jasnan Singh. Jasnan Singh, raise your hand. Which thing has a manufactured in a GNA in Fagwara? It is as a desirable in a Sonalika tractors. Usme use hota hai. Mehul Bajaj. Bajaj. NC. Mehul Bajaj. Mehul, yes Mehul. कौन सी चीज बनाई जाती है GNA के अंदर? वो जरूरी है ऑटोमोबाइल्स के लिए. Yes Mehul.
Yes sir.
Answer. क्या चीज है जो बनाई जाती है GNA के अंदर? जो ऑटोमोबाइल्स में, व्हीकल्स में, स्कूटर्स में, बाइक्स में बहुत जरूरी है.
सर वो क्या कहते हैं, गियर्स एंड बेयरिंग्स.
सॉरी,
गियर्स एंड बेयरिंग्स.
गियर्स एंड बेयरिंग्स. और कुछ नहीं बनाते वहां. शॉकर्स बनते हैं GNA के अंदर. शॉकर्स बनते हैं सोनालिका के इंफ्लुएंस के अंदर. स्मॉल टाउन्स के अंदर ऐसी इंडस्ट्री सेटअप की जा रही है. इंडस्ट्री सेटअप क्यों हो रही है? इट्स अर्बन एग्लोमरेशन ड्यू टू एज इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ अ लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री. स्मॉलर एरियाज आर डेवलपिंग. Smaller areas are developing under influence of a large scale industries as the urban agglomeration. That I think you have to leave the class. Urban agglomeration. Clear? Urban agglomeration. Shockers manufactured in a GNA, axles and shockers manufactured in a GNA used in an automobile industry. Kyun ho raha hai? Ek badi industry uske saath choti units develop ho rahi hain. Same as cotton textiles, which are growing in a western parts of a country. Western parts of country, they are importing their materials from a small scale industries. Small scale industries. Afterwards, the production of a cotton used for a ginning purposes, separating of a cotton seeds and manufacturing of a yarn. Thread banaya jata hai. Thread ko large scale cotton textile industries ko de diya jata hai. Then through which as they manufacture the clothes. Cotton clothes manufacture kiye jate hain. उसको काटा जाता है, डाई किया जाता है, काटा जाता है, उससे स्टिच करके देन आफ्टरवर्ड्स एज अ कॉटन टेक्सटाइल्स आर सेलिंग इन अ मार्केट. टेक्सटाइल्स आर सेलिंग इन मार्केट. क्लियर? this is as a rule of a large scale industries and small scale industries. They are doing as a, some of the stages of manufacturing. They are neither manufactured as the final goods. Their goods are used as a raw material in a large scale industry. So this is as the urban agglomeration. Under influence of a large scale industries, when smaller industries are growing, are known as the urban agglomeration. Another example, in a south, when you are moving towards the south, at Bangalore, a large number of IT-based industries, IT, information technology-based industries, which has required as a softwares and hardwares. Softwares managed by the large-scale industry and the hardwares, the parts of a computer. These are manufactured from the small-scale units. Why they are developing? Because large-scale industry is there, which can be as a consume their products, which will manufacture in a small-scale industry. This is the urban agglomeration. एक इकोनॉमी के इन्फ्लुएंस में, एक इंडस्ट्री के इन्फ्लुएंस में छोटी छोटी स्मॉल स्केल यूनिट्स जब डेवलप होती हैं, दिस इज एज द एग्लोमरेशन. अब सही थे तक, जब बहुत सारी इंडस्ट्रीज मिलके काम करती हैं, यहाँ स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज कुछ बना रही हैं, विच इज यूज एज अ रॉ मटेरियल इन अ लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री, विच इज नोन एज अ एग्लोमरेशन इकोनॉमीज, द अर्बन इकोनॉमीज. क्लियर? टिल देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस? नेक्स्ट इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज. टिल देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस, एनी क्वेरीज रिलेटेड विद द factors affecting as a location of industries or either the urban economies, agglomeration economies. Next part as a classification of industries. Industries are generally classified into the different categories. The five categories are there on which we can be as a categorized, to classify industries. We can classify industries. First category as on the basis of scale. On the basis of scale. Now am I audible? Yes. Am I audible? Okay. So first, on the basis of a scale means level. On the basis of a capital, money investment, scale, and production. Three types of industries are there. Questions?